when people ask me, like, how's it like to be an artist? It's like asking you, how can you be a human? For me, being able to do art is like being free. As early as I can remember, I've always been into art. My parents were actually really supportive of me being an artist or pursuing art. They never discouraged me. My parents are actually very creative people. My mother, she's the kind of person who always likes things to be beautiful and organized. She always tried to teach that to us, her values of beauty and art. So I have her as an inspiration for my art. Another inspiration is my father. I don't really like to talk about it, but he passed away when I was in first year of college. But he's an inspiration because, unlike my mother, who likes things to be organized, my father was kind of a wild child, I guess, used to be a musician when he was younger. I guess I got my art from him because when he was in college, he used to do people's portraits and he used to draw stuff to make money on the side. I remember when I started sketching and started copying people, he would always be the first person I would show it to, so I would go to him and ask him if, like, Papa, is this good enough, or did I do it right, or what else am I missing? So he was always the one who would tell me that, okay, you have to add more shading, you have to use more black, like, your features are off. So till the time that he passed away, like, every time I would go home and I would make a work of art, he would always be the one, he would always be the first person I would ask for an opinion of. One of my last memories of him was actually the two of us staying up. I was painting something at that time and told me that I should never ever stop practicing it. Even though I'm not pursuing art as a career, maybe it's that I should always keep it in my life, keep it in my heart, and I should always practice. Most of my work actually comes from emotional things. So even the smallest reasons to be happy or to be sad are enough for me to try to make a piece of art. One of the reasons I do this is for myself. I have, like, a journal of how I've been feeling. It helps me to deal with, like, the constant stress in life. So when I'm really, really stressed out, this is what I do. I make art. I guess another reason for me making art is to make people understand something or to make them feel things. I can show them a picture and all of them can understand it. Art can connect people in that way and how it can let you express things when words aren't enough. But it's fun. It's like you have an imagination factory in your head. So I guess if I were to describe my art, it would always be kind of dreamlike. The most common thing they would say is that, oh, so, like, painting is your hobby. I want to tell them, no, it's not a hobby. It's a passion. It's part of me. And that's how important art is. It keeps me moving. That art is an ever-growing thing. My chosen medium is actually watercolor, which I've heard a lot of people say is like, the hardest medium ever. And, yeah, I think I'd have to agree. Once in a while, I'd sit down and then I'd take out all of my sketch pads and I'd look at the things that I've made, look at how I've changed as an artist throughout the years, and I'm proud to say that I've improved a lot. Art is something that you have to keep working at. You have to have the passion and the dedication, I guess, to keep going at it, to get better and better and better until you're at your best. But even then, fire inside you that won't let you stop at that. It's always been a part of myself as an artist that I've always loved. Feeling that curiosity to always strive to do better, to make things even better. And that was really fun because I got to meet a lot of different artists and talk to them and learn about their work and how what kind of things inspire them. Just say to other artists like myself and other aspiring artists and other people who want to start being an artist to try and be so controlling. It's that's how art is. You have to be yourself.